The next subset of molecules we'll look at when we're dealing with Vesper shapes is AXN complexes, where our ligand, or X, is going to be oxygen or sulfur, and a double bond is not required to attain an octet. So for example, we can look at different oxyanions. In this case, SO42-. Our central atom is going to be sulfur. It only shows up once. It's going to have 6 valence electrons. Our oxygens, there's 4 of them. Since they're a ligand, they do not contribute any electrons. This gives us a total of 6 valence electrons. Remember, we need to attain an octet, so this is why the sulfate ion has a 2- charge, because we need 2 electrons to give us a total of 8, which will be 4 pairs. In this case, we're going to have 4 bonding pairs and 0 lone pairs. This is going to tell us our hybridization is sp3. Our electron domain geometry is going to be a tetrahedron. And our molecular geometry is also going to be a tetrahedron, because we don't have any lone pairs around that central atom. So let's go ahead and start putting these oxygens around the sulfur. Again, we're going to put brackets around this because we have a 2- charge. So in this case, there's going to be no requirement of a double bond to reach the octet. Although we know that if the central atom is in the 3rd period of the periodic table or higher, we can have what we call an expanded octet. So this particular compound can have more than 8 electrons in its outer shell. So this is going to give rise to 4 more Lewis structures in addition to the one that we have drawn. So we can have the SO42-, and I'm not going to draw the entire bracket, so I'll just put a little bracket up here in the corner. If we can expand our octet, we can do this in a variety of ways. We can have just 1 double bond. We can have 2 double bonds. We can have 3 of the oxygens form double bonds. Or we can have all 4 oxygens form double bonds to this sulfur, and its octet can expand. One thing we can say is that these structures are not resonance structures, since the bonding around the central atom is different. And as a result, the overall energy has changed. So we need to come up with some type of a system to determine which of these structures is the most accurate. And this is going to lead to a new theory. And that theory is called formal charge. And when we look at a formal charge, we can say that the best Lewis structure is the one with the lowest energy. We can predict the lowest energy structure using formal charge. And the formal charge is going to equal the number of valence electrons minus the number of bonds minus the number of lone pair electrons. So now that we've determined what formal charge is, we can determine the best structure based on formal charge. And we'll come up with a set of rules. Rule number one is the best structure based on formal charge will be the one with no formal charge. And we'll get to how to calculate this in a second. The second rule is when formal charges are required, A, they should be small, B, there should be minimal charge separation, and C, the negative formal charge should be on the most electronegative atom. So these are the rules that we're going to follow when we look at formal charges. Another thing to note that in all cases, the charge on the atom must equal the sum of the formal charge. So now we can use these rules that we have in place to go back and determine which structure of the sulfate ion would be the best one based on the formal charge.